Hello everyone, this is Beverly and you are watching the Living Eclectic channel. We are in the kitchen today, it is Whip It Up Wednesday, and we are making chai tea. Before we talk about the products we're going to use, we're going to talk about the tools that we're going to need. We're going to need 1 teaspoon, which you see here, 1 small grater, which you see here, 1 small strainer on the far right, and 1 medium saucepan. You can use a smaller saucepan if you prefer, anything that would hold up to 2 cups of liquid. You are also going to need 1 of your favorite fall mugs and 1 wooden spoon to stir with. Okay, so now let's talk about what we're going to need as far as ingredients. I have a teaspoon here that I mentioned before, and the reason why we have this is because most items I'm going to mention are going to be measured out in teaspoons. The first item to the right are the whole cardamom pods. They have tiny little cardamom seeds inside, and you want to take 2 teaspoons of this and set that to the side. The next item up would be the cloves. You want 1 teaspoon of these. We have the red label tea here in the middle, and this is the box I'm showing you is the 15.5 ounces. It's a larger one. You're only going to need 4 teaspoons of that for this recipe. You're also going to need 1 teaspoon of the grated nutmeg. These are the whole nutmegs, in case you're wondering. And then the last item here, at least in this set, is going to be peppercorn. You can use this as an optional item, and you probably want to kind of chop these up or grate these up and then put them in your tea. 1 teaspoon for this recipe. You can use less or more depending on your taste. There is 1 or 2 actually optional items you can put to this recipe, and I'll just mention those. Pure cane sugar or some type of sweetener, and you'd also have an option to add ginger. That's very popular in chai tea. So those are the main ingredients, and now I'm going to take you to the liquid mixture so you know what we're using as a base. As a side note in regards to the cardamom, there is a cardamom powder that you can buy. I'm showing you the 4-ounce jar here in front of us. This can be used in place of the actual cardamom, but it's very potent in the jar where they have it all crushed. So the powder, you might want to be careful with that. If you're going to do this, I would recommend approximately 1/2 teaspoon. Now over here to the liquid portion of this recipe. I am using the Simple Truth brand. This is vanilla almond milk, and you can use any milk-based product that you want. It's very good with whole milk if you go that route. You can use skim milk or fat-free milk. You can also use soy milk. It's up to you on how you want to make the base, but you're going to need 2 cups of whatever base milk product that you decide to use. So 2 cups of that along with the other ingredients, and I'm going to show you how I mix it up. So here I put in my cardamom pods, and I take this and I kind of just mash down on this. You do not have to have really anything fancy in order to do this. You can simply use a small cup and your teaspoon that I have over here and just press with that teaspoon on the cardamoms like this inside the cup until they kind of pop open like this one. You can see how it's popped open, and that way the little tiny seeds that are inside actually come out into the milk mixture. Thank you. Okay, now that we have everything in our pan, we're going to go ahead and give this a good stir. I have turned the burner below, which I'm using electric, on medium heat. And I'm going to let this heat all the way through, not to scalding, just all the way through. And then I'm going to come back and show you what this looks like. Right now you can see the milk is very white, and all the items are on top floating around and getting all that goodness incorporated. I did put sugar in here, 1 teaspoon. You can, if you put sugar in yours, you'll be able to feel that grittiness on the bottom. I'm kind of going to stir this a little bit until the grittiness goes away. That way I know that it is, you know, been incorporated into the milk mixture. And then I'm going to let this just rest on its own while the heat does its job. Okay, so here is what it looks like about three to five minutes later, depending on the heat of your stove. The cardamom pods have expanded. They're kind of swollen at this point, and that's what you want. And you can also see almost everything is floating, including the tea. It's not boiling, it's very hot. And you can see if I move this stuff to the side that now the milk is a nice brownish type color. That's exactly what you want. You want to let this sit here probably for another 2 minutes, and then you're going to come back while it's cooled down a little bit, and then you're going to strain it into your cup. So I will bring you back when I'm getting ready to do that, and then I can have some tea. So previously we talked about the mini strainer that you would need. You just take this and put it directly on top of your cup, and then you're going to take your tea and pour it over that strainer just like this. When you do that, you can see that the items are caught in the top and they don't get in your tea. And you just do this until your cup is full. Now, if you want the rest of your tea to get a little darker, you can take everything that's in the strainer that's left over and put it straight back into your pan and let it sit there while you're sipping on this if you want to come back for a stronger cup a little later. So this is the finished product in my awesome little owl mug that I got at Michael's. That's what that looks like. And there's my chai tea. Yummy, yummy. Very easy recipe, guys. Anybody could probably make this. You can adjust the amounts of each item depending on your taste. You can omit or add anything you want, but that's the core base of a chai tea, really. And I just wanted to share. So I hope this finds you well on a nice autumn evening. And until next time, see you then.